I'm not a big fan of advertising, but once in a while, they get it right. The incredible jazz guitar of Wes Montgomery. I don't want to say there's the greatest blah, blah, blah of all time, the greatest, it doesn't exist. But if there's one jazz guitar album for you to ever check out, I actually listened to this album so much that I thought Wes was playing a Gibson 175 guitar with which he's pictured on the album, and I went and got myself one, thinking I'd be able to play like Wes. Only later I realized he's not playing the same model, he's playing a completely different model. He actually had to fly to New York to play with this very famous jazz musicians of the time, Tommy Flanagan, Percy Heath, Albert Heath, and he borrowed the guitar from Kenny Burrell. He didn't even fly with his own guitar. So, the legend of Wes Montgomery, did he really play with his thumb and not a guitar pick? Is that why he sounds the way he sounds? How did he come up with the genius use of playing in octaves? He said in an interview that he didn't want to disturb the neighbors and the octave sounded quieter when he was practicing at night. He started playing when he was 20, which is very, very, very late age to start. He was playing in a small club in Indianapolis. No one knew who he was, basically. And Julian Campbell Adderley comes to listen to him live. He goes out to a payphone. He calls the jazz label Riverside Records. He tells the head of the label, Oren Kipnews, you have to sign this guy now. This guy is going to be the greatest legend of all time. And as the story goes, this is the second album that was recorded. It's kind of unbelievable to listen to because usually people record and progress with each recording. Wes was already a complete master on his second album. My actual favorite is Mr. Walker, and you can hear phrases from this album and this solo in particular in literally every jazz guitarist alive. Pat Metheny, John Scofield. There's no one guitarist that isn't influenced by Wes Montgomery. We'd like to get you into jazz. Go to our channel, subscribe, leave a comment, share the content. Each week we're picking one of you guys and sending you a jazz record as a gift. See you next week.